updates, by the way, on Mirco Mueller. He's been released from hospital after being injured in the Devils' loss last night. That one was tough
scary.
To watch.
Very scary.
It's fresh in a period, so there's not a lot of traction on the ice, which seems funny, but he catches his both ends, his left and his right, and he doesn't get his hands out in front of him as his left hand dives in behind him. He was down. Everyone on the ice reacted like they were scared, like they recognized that it was a pretty serious situation. You know, he gave the thumbs up on the way off the ice, which was a positive sign.
Certainly was. And this is a positive sign as well. Mueller releasing a comment today. Just wanted to thank everybody for all your encouraging messages over the last couple of hours. And thank you to everyone on the medical staff for taking exceptional care of me while I wasn't doing so well. He went on to say, I didn't sustain any too serious injuries and at this moment hope to be back on the ice very soon. So it sounds like he's going to be fine.
I mean, when you watch that, it is every hockey player's, fans, parents, friends' worst fear is that that kind of incident, that kind of crash, head first in the boards, and the kind of damage that could ensue. And when he looked like he was down, and Michael Forlick was right on his back, it had to add a little bit more weight into the boards, and the panicked reaction of the guys on the ice. The guys on the ice know you're hurt. You're injured, and they're different. And when you're really hurt, they react.
Yeah.
And to see guys on Calgary as well waving for the trainers,
immediately,
you know, hurry.
Immediately.
It made your heart drop. I mean, you're really just like, oh my goodness, we just hope that he's okay. When you saw him move, that's your first, okay, things are heading the right direction. And to see that kind of tweet come out from him, we wish him well. Get well soon. Don't hurry back. Take your time. Make sure you're right. But sounds like things are going well. That is the scariest spot to be on the ice. It's the most dangerous spot, 4 to 6 feet away. When you go in head first, head down, happy to hear he looks like he's going
to
be okay.
Yeah, happy to hear that he's saying it's not too serious and he's going to be okay. Wishing him the best.